Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in the previous presentation, I introduced de Moivre's formula or de Moivre's theorem. And in this video, I'm going to show you a mathematical application of that theorem or that formula to obtain some trig identities. So let me share my screen with you and we can get down to business. Okay, so here is the problem. You're asked to write cos 5 theta in terms of cos theta by applying de Moivre's theorem or de Moivre's formula. So let's just remind ourselves what that is. For each integer n and all real theta, we have the following relationship. Okay, so how do we do it for this particular example? Well, we're going to start with n equals 5 in this relationship. Okay, so we get a cos 5 theta there, a sine 5 theta there, and a power 5 up there. Okay, and that's, you know, if it was you wanted to write cos 6 theta or something, you would start with n equals 6. Okay, so I'm just going to shorten de Moivre to DM. Okay, so let's apply de Moivre with n equals 5. And we'll get the following. Yeah? Okay, so we've got a cos 5 theta there, and we want to write this in terms of this. So now, cos 5 theta is the real part of this right-hand side. Now, because these two expressions are equal, this will be a complex number or a complex expression, and so will this. The real parts of both sides have to be equal. Okay, so this is another important step. So equate the real parts. Now, if you wanted sine 5 theta, you would equate the imaginary parts. Okay, so let's take this, that's the real part of that. And we don't know what the real part of this is. It's going to be a bit messy, but we can write that we're sort of interested in the real part by just writing this RE of whatever this expression is. Okay, so now it's up. Oh, hang on, let me just adjust my camera. Okay. All right, we don't know what the real part of this is, but we're going to work it out, okay? And then we'll have our identity. Okay, so we have to do an expansion here. And for that, I'm going to use Pascal's triangle. Okay, so we've got a power of 5 here. So, you know, with Pascal's triangle, you form a triangle, you start with these 1s, and then you have 1s down the outside sort of diagonal, and to form the numbers inside, you just add the numbers above it. So I'd have 1s on the outside, 1 plus 1 is 2, you'd write that sort of in the middle. Then you continue, 1, so 1 and 2 is 3, 2 and 1, 3, and 1 down the edge. And you keep on going until you get down to the desired level. Okay. One more. So that'll be squared, cubed, power 4, power 5. 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, and 1. Okay, so this is the row that we're interested in. And these numbers give us the coefficients of this expansion. Okay, so this is Pascal's triangle. All right, so what we try to do is expand this and then look at the real part. Now, it looks like it's going to get messy, but we're just going to cherry pick the real parts out of it, so we don't actually have to simplify it as much as you would think. Okay, so we take this, raise it to the power 5, and multiply by 1. Okay, then decrease this power by 1 and increase the power of I sine theta by 1 and multiply by, this is your coefficient, so we're going to get 5 cos to the power 4 theta times I sine theta, all to the power 1. Okay, move on to the next one. Decrease this power by 1, increase this power by 1, and the coefficient's going to be 10. Okay, so okay, again, move on to the next number. Decrease this power by 1, increase this power by 1, and we'll actually have the same coefficient. Okay, and now move on to this one. Decrease this power by 1, increase this power by 1. I'm sure you can see the pattern now. Oops. Okay, and the last one, we'll decrease this power by 1, it'll become 0, so just 1, and this will become to the power 5. Phew, okay, that's a long expression here. But notice we're only interested in the real part of this expression. So wherever I see an I can ignore it. Okay, so let's see if we can do that. Well, there's no I's there, so the real part, that's definitely in the real part, cos to the power 5, cos theta to the 5. Now, what about here? Well, I have an I there, so that, we can forget about that. Here I'm going to have an I squared. Now, remember, I squared equals negative 1. Okay, so this will become negative sine squared theta, and the whole thing will be real. Okay? So I'll get, that'll definitely be in the real part here. Yeah? Okay, so we're moving on. That's going to be an I cubed. Now, I cubed will be negative I, so that is not going to be real. What about this one? Well, I to the power 4, that's I squared times I squared, negative 1 times negative 1. So the I's are going to disappear. So that's definitely going to be real. Okay, so I'm going to get 5 cos sine to the power 4. And over here I'm going to get I to the power 5. Well, that's going to leave me with some sort of I, so that again will not be real. Okay. Alright, so I've basically gone from this mess to 3 terms. So I do have an identity now, but it's not quite in the form that we're asked to get it in. We want cos 5 theta in terms of cosine theta, right? So that's in terms of cosine theta. This isn't, and this isn't. But what we can do is replace, say, sine squared with 1 minus cosine squared. Okay? So I can replace sine squared with 1 minus cosine squared here. And this is sine squared all squared. So I can replace sine to the power 4 with 1 minus cosine squared all squared. Okay. Okay, so I've written sine to the power 4 as sine squared all squared. Okay, so if you expand this out now, you will get the following. Okay, so I invite you to just do the expansions and the simplification. And you get your identity in terms of cosine theta. So this would be your identity. Okay, cos 5 theta equals 16 cos to the power 5 minus 20 cos to the power 3 plus 5 cos theta. Okay, now A good question is, why would I want to do that? Why would I want to write this as this? Well, one potential application, at least to save you time, is when you're integrating trig expressions. Okay, let's say you wanted to integrate this. Okay, now to integrate this is not short because you've got these powers here. Okay, but if you can write this as cosine 5 theta, it's easy to integrate because it's easy to integrate cosine 5 theta with respect to theta. It'll be something like 1 on 5 sine 5 theta. Okay, so although we've gone from sort of simple to complicated here, if you wanted to integrate this, you would go back to here and you would just do the integration in one step. Okay? Okay, so that's my presentation. Hope you enjoyed it. In forthcoming videos, I'll do another example of de Moivre's theorem and its application, perhaps this time using sines instead of cosines. So if you have any comments, any questions, any feedback, I'd love to hear it. Hope you can join me for the next presentation. Thanks for watching. Bye.